Hello, internet friends. I hope you're all doing great. Today, my friend Jake, hello Jake, and I will be reviewing and talking about Edge Dancer, which is like the second 0.5 book in the Stormlight Archives. It's like between Words of Radiance and Oathbringer. And yeah, this is a spoiler-free part. It will be like 2 minutes long, so get ready. Let's go.
I am Ivan, and this is The Book Place.
3 years ago, Lyft asked a goddess to stop her from growing older, a wish she believed was granted. Now, in Edge Dancer, the barely teenage nascent Night Radiant finds that time stands still for no one. Although the young Azshish Emperor granted her safe haven from an executioner she knows only as Darkness, court life is suffocating the free-spirited Lyft, who can't help heading to Yido when she hears that relentless darkness is there hunting people like her with budding powers. The downtrodden in Yido have no champion, and Lyft knows she must seize this awesome responsibility. As always, the tone in this book is like a lighthearted seriousness, although this is more lighthearted than any of the others. Would you agree, Jake?
Yeah, this is the most lighthearted Stormlight Sanderson, like, just thing in the Cosmere.
Yeah, exactly. It's probably like The Hobbit, you know, when compared to Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, that's a very good comparison.
Yeah, and then the writing style is like super easy as always. And recommendation. Do you want to recommend it before I do, Jake?
Yeah, I would recommend you read it between Words of Radiance and Oathbringer. It's not as good as Words of Radiance or Oathbringer, but it's a side quest, but it can. You know, I enjoyed it. I know some people don't like Lyft, but I think not even for the stuff with Lyft, there's a couple other side characters in here, and I feel like the stuff that happens with them is almost more important.
Yeah.
Also, it's like 40,000 words. You can read that in like a day or 2 days. It's like an
Yeah,
11th of
exactly.
Oathbringer. So
Yeah, it's like what, 150 pages without counting the first chapter?
yeah,
Yeah, because
it's really short.
Yeah, and the first chapter, by the way, is the longest one, but it's also like a copy paste from the interlude in Words of Radiance. So you could skip it if you just read it.
Yeah, you don't have to read that.
Yeah, I personally didn't like that much this book. However, I think it's good to read it. I mean, if you're reading the series, read it, of course. And yeah, and it's important for the side characters, which have some cool moments. That's true. The side characters had some pretty cool moments.
Yes.
And
So, like, you know, I gave this like 7.5 out of 10, which
yeah, so yeah.
I enjoy it. I really like Lyft isn't one of my favorite Brandon characters,
Yeah.
but that's because I kind of like all of them in Stormlight. That being said, I throughout the entire series, I'm just kind of like, can we get back to like the main mission now? Throughout the entire book, it's like,
Yeah,
you know, when
exactly.
you're playing a video game and it's like the world's about to end, and you know, an
Chase the fox.
NPC's like, "Hey, I need you to find this per my purse," and you're just like, "Yeah, sure, I can do that."
Yeah,
And you know,
exactly.
it's a well-written story about finding a purse, but it's never going to be as interesting as like an actual Stormlight book.
Yeah, exactly. That's a good point. Like, I wonder if I would have enjoyed it more if it was like a standalone, you know, its own thing. Separate
Maybe.
from the Stormlight Archives.
Maybe.
Yeah. Well, with all that said, that's it for the spoiler-free part. And yeah, everybody watching, you can watch the second part, which is a spoiler-filled part, next. And that's the fun part. Remember to follow us on Instagram, The Book Place Podcast, and on our Discord. And yeah, that's it. Peace.